goodbye to all of the yeshiva. As a result of her diabetes disease, she did not become older than 6 years. But we never forget this little girl. Having said this, I think now is the time to switch to the happier part of this video. But first, I just want to say that I hope you will enjoy this video. And I also hope that if after watching and listening turns out that you really enjoyed it, that you want to be so sweet to let me know by giving the video the well-known blue thumbs up. I would really appreciate that. So, the water feels great. And in case you like this video so much that you want to see more and more of these videos, then I say please subscribe to my channel and also hit the notification bell. Then you are always up to date. Because then you receive a notification every time a new video is added. And I can assure you that many more videos will follow. So now it's time to catch Roxy. Here we go. Oh dear, you don't have to swim now. It's okay. In the meantime that Roxy is undergoing her weekly freshening up part, I'm gonna tell you how our club of 5 came into being. So, then I now start with the story. It all started 11 years ago. I had wanted a Chihuahua for a long time, so I was searching the internet to find one that would suit us. I also knew for a long time that my husband wasn't that enthusiastic as I was. But on the other hand, he knew for years that if I had something in my mind that I really wanted, that it was far from easy, as nearly impossible to talk it out of my mind. So I'm pretty sure he knew that it could only be a matter of time before a Chihuahua would come and join us. So I think that he then decided that he better could start already to mentally prepare himself for the moment. But from then on, it took me another 7 weeks to come across the ad I thought it was worth responding to. So I immediately contacted the advertiser, and we made an appointment for that same day and evening to see if there was a click between the Chihuahua and us. We decided to go there without kids, because we first wanted to see if this was really the Chihuahua that suited us. If it turned out that she didn't suit us, then at least we wouldn't have to disappoint the kids. So I contacted a friend and asked her if she would come over that evening to look after the kids for a few hours. And luckily for us, that was possible. So we told the kids that we would be going to the cinema that night, and that Marilyn would come over to babysit for that evening. And as expected, both kids had no problem with Marilyn coming babysitting, because she was always playing games with them or coloring and doing crafts with them. But the most loved part of having Marilyn as a babysitter was that Marilyn always allowed them to stay up longer. So the kids were totally happy. They were already looking at each other with a small grin on their faces, with which they gave each other the message that Marilyn always allowed them to stay up a bit longer. We always knew that, because we made the deal with Marilyn ourselves. But the kids didn't know that. They always thought it was a little secret between Marilyn and them. So because of that, they gave each other that silent, meaningful look. I loved seeing that connection between them. But that aside now, because I had told you guys to tell you a story about our Chihuahuas, not about our kids. So that evening, Marilyn arrived about 5 o'clock, because we had asked if she would like to join us for dinner before we left. The appointment was that we would be there at 8:30. We had to drive for about an hour before we should arrive to our destination. So we left home at 6:15. So that we had a march of 15 minutes, just in case that it was needful for whatever reason. After asked us to come in. She walked ahead of us into the kitchen and asked us to take a seat at her kitchen table. Because we had now been on the road for an hour, she insisted that we have a freshly brewed cup of coffee with her. So we took seat at the table. She poured in the coffee. And in the meantime, she told us that after we agreed that afternoon that we would go there in the evening to meet them and their Chihuahua, she immediately went to the bakery to get something tasty with the coffee. Not knowing what we liked, she bought four different pastries so we could choose something ourselves. How sweet is that? I remember I chose a piece of apple pie. And let me tell you, thinking of it right now makes that I could almost taste the flavor again. While we enjoyed the coffee and the cake, we went through some questions we wanted to ask each other. For example, the woman wanted to know if we were confident that our children were sufficiently aware that they had to be careful not to fall on it or step on it accidentally. I swore to her that such a thing wouldn't happen. After we had asked each other quite a few questions and we had finished the coffee with the delicious pastry, I really couldn't wait any longer to meet the Chihuahua. My patience was totally gone. Now I have to say that the people who know me know that being patient isn't one of my best qualities anyway. But compared to other times, in my opinion, I had already managed to keep my patience quite well this time. Although you don't hear me say that it was easy. I'm guessing that piece of apple pie helped me by that. That's the only reasonable explanation I can imagine. But okay, so you understand that I kindly declined the offer for a second cup of coffee. And that I told her I almost couldn't wait any longer to meet the Chihuahua to see if there was a click between us. She got up from the table and asked us to follow her into the room next to the kitchen. So we followed her. And there she was, a cute little Chihuahua that looked so adorable, her mother laying next to her. I asked if the mother Chihuahua would allow me to touch them both, or that I would then risk to lose a piece of my finger. The woman answered that the mother was a very good-natured mother, her as well as her baby. And less than a half minute later, I was already sitting on the floor, holding mother and daughter in my arms. But then, suddenly something happened to me, something I never thought about before. A very mixed feeling came over me. From one side, I was happy, because at that moment I already knew that this was going to be our little Chihuahua. On the other side, that feeling of joy was suddenly overshadowed by the thought that I would soon walk out the door with her little one, while the mother would stay there alone, looking in vain for her baby, which she should never could find back anymore. I hated that thought. But I also realized that if I wouldn't buy the puppy, someone else would do it someday. Then my husband said to me, "If we don't take her now, somebody else will do it one of these days, and who knows what her life will look like then." Then I told him that I was thinking exactly what he just said. So at that point, I knew for 100% sure that we were going to take her home with us. I asked if the lady would take the puppy with her for a minute, because I wanted to say goodbye to the poor mother. While having a lump in my throat and tears rolling down my cheeks, I told her that I felt sorry for her and also promised her that I would take very good care of her baby. Although I was aware that she probably didn't understand anything of what I had whispered to her, I did it anyway, because I hoped that I could convey the meaning of my words to her emotionally. At least I did try. And then it was time to sweep myself back together. With pain in my heart, I walked away from her and followed the lady back into her kitchen. There she handed me the puppy, which she already had wrapped in a blanket. was December 3rd. It was freezing, and meanwhile it had also started snowing. The windows of our car were already frozen, so we had to clear them first. And then our ride home could begin. But now I'm done baiting Roxy. That means we have come to the end of this video. If you like to hear how this story does go further, then be sure to subscribe and also to hit the notification bell. Then you will get a notification as soon as I post a new video. In this next video, our Senna is getting her weekly refresh pod. And in the meantime, I'll tell you the sequel to this story. So for now, I want to thank you for watching this video. And hopefully I see you soon at the next one.